So let us start. Today I'm going to cover one more important topic from service-oriented architecture, and the topic is advantages. So common benefits provided by service-oriented architecture, then disadvantages we can say the pitfalls of adopting service-oriented architecture, and misperception. So the meaning of misperception means a wrong or incorrect understanding or interpretation. So let us start. The important topic from service-oriented architecture is advantages, disadvantages, and misperception of service-oriented architecture. So first, I'm going to cover some important tangible benefits of adopting service-oriented architecture. Again, through these tangible benefits, we'll get the idea that why the IT organization adopting service-oriented architecture. The first important benefit or advantage of service-oriented architecture is it improved the integration. Because of service-oriented architecture, the organization is able to develop the web services or web API, and using that web services and web API, the organization is able to integrate with other organization or within or outside. So integration of different application within the organization and outside the organization. So both the problems are again solved with the help of service-oriented architecture, with the help of cross-application integration. So within the organization, cross-application integration means some applications are developed in .NET, ASP.NET, some applications develop in the organization with the help of Java technology, or some applications develop in the organization with the help of PHP technology. So within the organization, sharing the data amongst the different technologies is possible with the help of service-oriented architecture. So organization adopting this service-oriented architecture because of this particular benefit. It improves the integration. So cross application integration within the organization and outside the organization is possible with the help of service oriented architecture. Therefore, organizations are again adopting the service oriented architecture. Reusability. Services are reusable. So whenever we are developing the web services and web API, these web services and web API are reusable applications or the programs within different services. So you can use, you can execute these web services or web API separately or in a group. So you combine the web services, web API. So it gives you the reusability features, because service-oriented architecture is again based on object-oriented architecture. So object-oriented analysis and designing. After that, service-oriented architecture is using that architecture, is based on that architecture. Therefore, it provide you inherent reusability. Service-oriented architecture is a streamlined architecture. It's a systematic way of analyzing the web services or web API, designing the web services and web API, testing the web services and web API. So it's a streamlined architecture. It gives you the systematic way of developing the web services and web API, and that web services and web API is nothing but the solution given by the service-oriented architecture for communicating with different organizations, for sharing the data amongst the different organizations within and outside. So it's a streamlined architecture that gives you systematic way of analyzing, designing, and testing the web services and web API. The next benefit is it establishing the standardized XML data representation. We know that the SOAP-based service provide you XML data representation. Again, the REST is providing you XML, JSON, JavaScript object notation, plain text. So data representation is possible in different way in REST-based API or RESTful web services. But the common thing is what? XML is common between the two types of web services, SOAP-based and REST-based. So XML data representation. So if the technology is again able to interact with XML, then you can the organization is able to develop the web services and web API in that technology. So XML, it's a universal language, and through the XML we can the organization can able to exchange the data using the XML. So XML input and XML output is shared amongst the organization. So establishing standard. Nowadays, the organization investing in service-oriented architecture, because they know that the future requirement is the future is what bright for this service-oriented architecture, and organization is investing in communication infrastructure, because that communication infrastructure is required in deploying the web services and web API. So to deploy the web services and web API, you required the server, web server. And for that web server, for that communication infrastructure, the organization started already investment. So SOA is what? Long-term investment from the organization point of view. Then it gives you best of breed alternatives. Service oriented architecture provide you best of breed alternatives, means the organization can develop the web services in any technology as per the demand of their programmer, not restricting towards one technology. So they may adopt any technology. So they may develop the web services in any technology. And second organization may call that web service in any technology, using any technology. So in the olden days, organizations are again stick toward the one technology. For example, some organization just stick towards the Microsoft technology. So they are not ready to adopt any other technology. So that problem is again solved. See, if the organization is restricting towards the .NET technology, then they are able to develop the web services and calling that web services in .NET technology. But the second organization, they may prefer their own technologies. Suppose the second organization is well versed with the PHP or Python, so they can able to access, develop and access the web services or web API in their own technologies. So it provide you best of breed alternatives. So these are the some of the advantages of service oriented architecture. Again, there are few disadvantages or drawbacks or pitfalls of adopting service oriented architecture. The first pitfall or drawback of service oriented architecture is the organization building the service oriented architecture like the traditional distributed architecture. So if we adopted the traditional distributed architecture, in that case we are not getting the advantages of web services and web API, because the traditional distributed architectures are using that architecture, the application means organization that not gives you the more security. The application developed in using the distributed architecture is less secured. But when we shift it towards the web services or web API, it gives you more security. So that may be one of the pitfall that some organizations building the service oriented architecture like the traditional distributed architecture, they have to adopt the RESTful services, because RESTful services provide you much more security Even the SOAP-based services also provide you SSL type of security. So some organizations are again implementing the service-oriented architecture like the traditional distributed architecture. So they are not getting the advantages of service-oriented architecture. Then the second common pitfall is or drawbacks of service-oriented architecture is not standardizing the service-oriented architecture. So different organization adopt the different way of analyzing the web services or web API. There are different ways. I'm going to cover in the third chapter, I'm going to cover this particular topic that some organization develop the WSDL first. So they develop the WSDL first, and after developing the WSDL, then they develop the web services. So this type of approach is called as top-down approach. So developing the WSDL, and after developing the WSDL, after that they develop the web services. So this approach is called as top-down approach of development of web services or web API. Some organization prefer the bottom-up approach. Most of the organization nowadays prefer the bottom-up approach, means they develop the web services first, and after executing the web services, the WSDL is created and then that WSDL is shared. In first case, WSDL is again created first, but in bottom-up, first web services are again developed, and after execution of the web services, the WSDL is again created and that WSDL is shared. So in traditionally, top-down approach is followed by some organization, and nowadays organization follow the bottom-up approach. Some organization follows the agile, meet in middle, means they combine both the approach, top-down and bottom-up. So it's a complex strategy. It's a complex strategy adopted by some organization. So organizations are again using different way for developing the web services. So no, not standardizing the service-oriented architecture. So that may be one of the pitfall. Not creating a transition plan. So organizations are not planning the service-oriented architecture. Means if the requirement arises, then only they develop the web services. But they are not properly develop a transition plan for developing or adopting the service-oriented architecture. They just adopt the service-oriented architecture, or they just develop the web services based on end user requirement. No proper planning is again adopted by the organization. So not creating a transition plan. If the organization prepare the transition plan, then they may get the more advantages of this service-oriented architecture. Some organization not understanding the service-oriented architecture performance requirement. They are developing the web services and web API, but the one part is missing in their application is the performance requirement. If the complex web service is there, then that to execute that complex web service, the performance is again degraded. But that may be the one of the disadvantage of service-oriented architecture, that organization not giving the importance to the performance. They are just giving the importance to development of web services and web API. The performance criteria is not considered by the organization. Therefore, the performance requirement is one of the pitfall of adopting service-oriented architecture. Again, the organization develop the web services and web API, but they are not providing, they are not increasing the security. We know that the web services and web API provide you secure socket layer security. Encryption, decryption is possible. 128-bit secured socket layer encryption is available while developing the web services, but the programmers are not giving much more importance for security. They are interested in sharing the information. But Nowadays, the organization is giving more importance to security. But in some organization, this may be one of the pitfalls or drawbacks of service adopting service-oriented architecture, that they not understand the web service security parameter. Not keeping in touch with product platform and standard development. So in case of web services, you must know different technologies. But some organization means some developer, if the developer is well versed with ASP.NET technology, then they are not concentrating on other technologies. Again, the Java developer, they are not concentrating on other technologies. What is happening in the ASP.NET technology or PHP or in Python? So that may be one of the pitfall of service-oriented architecture, that not keeping in touch with the product platform and standard development. They just concentrate on their own technologies. So that may be one of the pitfall. So .NET programmers are again concentrating on .NET only, and Java professional are again concentrating on Java technology only. So they are not keeping in touch with product other product platforms. So these are the some of the drawbacks of adopting service-oriented architecture. The next topic is the misperception about SOA, myths about SOA, a wrong or incorrect understanding or interpretation of service-oriented architecture. So let us see some of the myth related with service-oriented architecture. The first misperception related with service-oriented architecture is the service-oriented an application that uses web services is a service-oriented architecture. In some, we can say that it is true in some cases. So I can say that this statement is 50 to 60% true, but not 100%. Therefore, it is one of the misperception. So only using the web services, we cannot say that it's a service-oriented architecture. So 50 to 60%, this sentence is correct. It's a misperception, not 100% service-oriented architecture. Then the second sentence is, SOA is just a marketing term used to rebrand the web services. Yes, initially also in the olden days also, the organization developed the SOAP-based services. But it's in somewhat sense, it is true that. So SOA is a marketing term used by some organization for rebranding the web services. So in somewhat, we can say that service-oriented architecture is just a marketing term, but it's more than marketing. Therefore, it is one of the misperception. Then the next is SOA is just a marketing term used to rebrand distributed computing with web services. Again, this sentence is also partly true, but it more than that. Service-oriented architecture is more than that. Not only by using the distributed computing, but the security is again increased, and the use of this service-oriented architecture is increased. Then the next sentence is SOA simplifies distributed computing. Okay, in somewhat sense, we can say that. Okay, it simplifies the distributed computing. But SOA is more than that. Then the next misperception related with service-oriented architecture is an application with web services that uses web service extension, web service star, asterisk, means web service extension is service-oriented architecture. No, it is not the case. It is not the case. We know that the organization, while developing the web services, we have to concentrate on web service specification So every web service include addressing, reliable messaging, correlation, policy framework, metadata exchange, security, notification framework, and eventing. So that is there, but it is more than that. So an application with web services, and that web services follows the different extensions provided by the web services, is service oriented. Yes, in somewhat sense we can say that 50 to 60% it is true, but not 100%. And the next is, if you understand the service orient web services, you won't have a problem in building service oriented architecture. So developing the web services is a part of service oriented architecture, but you must know how to analyze the application using service oriented principle, then how to design the application web services or web API systematically, how to test the web services using different application testing tool. So that is the case. So if you understand the web services, you won't have a problem in building service oriented architecture. So it's a misperception. So knowing, understanding the web services is good for service oriented architecture, but along with web services, along with web API, you must know the systematic way of service oriented analysis, designing and testing of service oriented application. So it is more than that. So these are the few. One more misperception related with service oriented architecture is, once you go service oriented architecture, everything becomes interoperable. So this is not the case. Once you go to service oriented architecture, everything becomes inoperable, means we cannot convert the standalone application or web based application 100% with service oriented architecture. So that is not the case. This sentence is also partly true, but not fully true. So this is what, this is also one of the misperception related with service oriented architecture. So today I have covered the advantages of service oriented architecture, then disadvantages of service oriented architecture, and few misperception related with service oriented architecture. So from the exam point of view, or from understanding point of view, these advantages, disadvantages and misperceptions are important topic from my side. So today I'm covering this much only. Thank you.